Welcome to this session on preparing an application to deploy. In this session, we're going to discuss how to tag a version of an application and create its deployment plan. That will include how to create and validate the deployment plan, add deployment notes to it, and potentially edit or discard the plan. So let's go ahead and get started. When we're preparing an application to deploy, the application itself may be going through the development process. It will go through several different iterations, and when it meets a key development milestone at the end of an iteration, that stable state would usually correspond to a new version of the application. That new version may need to be deployed to the testing environment, while the development team moves on to begin working on the next iteration. The first step to do that is to prepare the deployment of that application. In Lifetime, there are generally two steps to prepare a deployment for a different environment. Tag the version of the application that has its latest changes in it, and create a deployment plan so that the application and its dependencies can be moved to the new environment. So to do this, we will be tagging an application version in Lifetime. And this is basically like taking a snapshot of the application at a current time and associating a new version number with it. And when we see this inside of Lifetime, we'll be able to see, when we look at the details of our application, an app version number. When this app version number has a plus next to the version, it means that that specific application code has been modified in that environment and a new version could be tagged, because this is no longer the most current version. So, to tag a version, all we have to do is click the Tag Version button, and to do that, a user must have Change and Deploy permissions to be able to see that button and be able to do it. Lifetime displays the modules that have changed, who changed them last, and when they were changed. So, in this case where we're looking at our OSMDB application, we can see that it has two modules, the OSMDB and the OSMDB core. We can see which ones have been changed, and when we go to tag it, we have to give it a new version number, and we can optionally give it a description. You can think of these as release notes before we actually press the finalized tag version button. Now, once we've done that, as we're tagging the different versions of the application, each of those versions becomes a frozen state or a frozen package of that code at that given time. The plus sign will disappear because it will become the latest and newest version, and if we wish to see the version history at any given time, we can go to our application and click on the version history. And it will show the most recent version at the top with all of the previous versions below. So here we can see a 0.1 version that was then upgraded to 1.0. Now, after tagging a version, any changes are going to have that plus sign next to it, which is good. Something else to notice is that if you deploy an application for the first time in a particular environment, Lifetime will automatically tag it as a 0.1 version. So here we can see both of those concepts. SilkUI Web was probably recently deployed for the very first time as its 0.1, and here Todo was deployed as 0.1, and then someone made a change to it, where the plus shows that that isn't the same version that was originally tagged. Now, once we have the tags ready and we know what we'd like to tag our application, so in this case we're interested in maybe moving it to 1.0, then we need to create a deployment plan. And we should do that when the application is at its stable state, we've picked the right tag version number, and then we'll see that there's a green icon between the environments, which says deploy. By asking it to deploy, it's going to begin creating a deployment plan. The first step in creating a deployment plan is to select the applications that are going to be part of this deployment. So here we can see it asking which applications would we like to deploy to the quality environment. So by showing OSMDB, we now can click the drop-down menu and we can go ahead and choose to add this one to the deployment plan. Once we've saved all the applications that we'd like to add to the plan, we can go ahead and save that plan. Now, when we come into the interface, we may also see that we'll have buttons here that will say you can tag and deploy something at the same time. So this option occurs when it knows how to move things to the next minor version, and we're only going to be dealing with a single application. Now, once we have something like the ability to deploy because a plan has been created to do that, the validate now will come up at the top of the environment list. And that's there to make sure that Lifetime can do an impact analysis before those applications are actually going to be deployed. Because we wouldn't want the application to be deployed if there would be anything wrong with the integrity of the destination environment because of the deployment, or if our application has any broken or missing references. So as long as the impact analysis doesn't detect any problems, then what will happen is the validation sets will turn into green buttons that will allow us to go ahead and continue and actually perform the deployment. Now we do need to have permissions to do the deployment, and those permissions are change and deploy permissions or above. And we need that in the destination environment, or the user's only going to be able to save the plan and they won't be able to execute the plan. But there's no problem with a user who doesn't have permission, say in quality, to go ahead and create the plan and then pass that along to a user who has enough permissions to be able to go ahead and execute the plan. So if we go back real quick, we'll just see that again. Down at the bottom, it shows you if you are a particular user that doesn't have the capability, you can't do deploy now because you don't have permissions to deploy the plan to the quality environment. So if a user does get to the point where they are able to do the deployment, then some of the things that they may wish to add are deployment notes. Because as we're creating the plan, notes may be important to say that when you get to the next environment, you may want to do these things as well. So we can save the plan and the notes, and we can always edit and add these notes at any given time. So here we can see the deployment notes suggesting that to get the movie posters, the application is going to use a RESTful API, and we need to go ahead and test that API in the next environment. And the last step that we may encounter is that if a plan has been changed before the deployment, we may wish to discard it. So we can change any deployment plan anytime we need, and we could also just discard and throw it away. So users can begin defining these deployment plans collaboratively so that groups can kind of put different pieces into the deployment plan that are necessary, or at least share the notes to be able to do that. So once our deployment plan is saved, it's ready to go, but at any given time, we can go ahead and discard that plan. So that's it for preparing an application to deploy. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.